Packy has kept the Mexican-American heritage look, but he has dropped the sombrero.
Dropped the mustache also.
Yeah. That comes on and off for him.
And he comes into the ring. Resplendent.
That's a classy rope.
De La Hoya and Alexander, and now let's talk about the keys to victory for these two. Brought to you by AutoZone.
For De La Hoya, don't be careless. He can't afford to just wail away and be reckless. In a variety pack, I think he should throw different kinds of punches against Alexander. He can't be too one-dimensional. For Alexander, he's got to counter him early. And when I say hold, 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 if De La Hoya is getting on a roll with him, if I was him, I'd hold so much, I wouldn't care if they took a point away.
Well, we'll see how Alexander decides to fight him. Let's get to the introductions now with Michael Bunn.
And Top Rank Incorporated, in association with the undisputed and undefeated King of Beer, Budweiser, presents the featured bout of the evening. This bout is sanctioned by the California State Athletic Commission. The three judges scoring this bout are Gwen Adair, Lou Moret, and Robert Byrd. All the other officials at ringside shall remain the same. And now, ladies and gentlemen, from the famous Hollywood Palladium here in Hollywood, California, is in the lightweight division. The referee for this contest is Chuck Hassett. Introducing first, fighting out of the red corner, wearing the white trunks with red letters, weighing in at 133 pounds. He's fighting out of San Francisco, California, and brings a good record, 15 victories, 3 KOs, against 6 defeats and 2 draws. Ladies and gentlemen, Paris, the Lion, Alexander. His opponent across the ring, wearing the multicolored trunks and weighing in at an even 134 pounds. From Los Angeles, California, East LA to be exact. He brings with him a gold medal from the 1992 Olympics. He's 2-0 as a professional, both by knockout victory. Ladies and gentlemen, Oscar the Golden Boy.
Question as to who the crowd is here to see.
Have you ever seen a whole corner as bedecked in the perfectly matching outfits?
Like
those
it.
Guys
nice.
In entertainment, they call it a money look, right? That's what they have.
What a repeat. We're working on boys today. Good luck.
So De La Hoya and Alexander, and the fashion statement now made. Paris Alexander looking the part of the confident fighter.
Very, very articulate, intelligent guy who understands what he needs to do. He happens to be a behavioral therapist for senior citizens when he's not boxing. He loves boxing and says, I'm not going to just fall down for this guy. And if he comes after me quickly, he said, I will hit him with something. We'll see.
We'll see. He's not a guy, as you can tell by his record, who's apt to knock you out. Only 3 knockouts and 15 wins.
He's not a huge puncher. What he does have is durability, and they'd like to see a little bit of that, I guess.
And he's a pest. And yeah, he had a complimentary way.
He made it difficult for Pena to hit him. You heard one of my keys to victory, that is bold.
First he closed his eyes, and then he held.
At least to get through two or three of those punches, and they don't do it.
Okay. think Alexander really hurt by it, but he made it look all too easy. As I mentioned earlier, they really do have him headed on a very fast track. They want to fight him main event very quickly. Incidentally, I should point out, he's the youngest main event fighter that we have ever had here on Top Rank Boxing.
Alexander might make some history, though. He might make get to the second round. I don't know what they're able to do with
Delahoya yet. I think Delahoya would kind of like that, too, someone inside him. I think he might get a little bit of work in.
Watching him over in Barcelona at the Olympics, his jab is a staple and used it to carve out several decision wins.
What he does show is a lot of, not only patience for a guy who is an amateur fighter, but he's right on balance, doesn't throw bad punches.
Now, you know, I almost hate myself for saying this, but you really have to look back to Sugar Ray Leonard to see a guy who this early in his career was right. Except a guy that wins a gold medal is highly marketable, would be in main events on television this quickly.
I want to move less than 10 rounds. They were quickly. In fact, they're talking about that going Alexander against the left hand. Boy, he is so strong.
And I'm sure Paris, who, as I said, just didn't think this was going to happen to him. He's sitting here thinking, oh, man, this guy's stronger than I thought.
Look, if you watch Delahoya as an amateur, you would think that.
Jeff Mayweather in March in the 10 rounds. Jeff Mayweather has been fighting 10 round main events with pretty good fighters for a couple of years. But it's going to may have to fight Roger Mayweather by April.
That's true.
A couple of weights just enough.
Right hand rocks Alexander again. Really agree with the stoppage, I don't think, but I think it only could have gotten uglier, to tell you the truth.
I don't know if Paris Alexander would have done anything more at that point. I mean, they could have let it go, I guess, one more knockdown, but he had been knocked down two or three times, wasn't showing any offense, and I just have to wonder if he would have been effective at that point. I agree with that. I don't think that's in any way any kind of protection for Delahoya or anything of that nature. Here's the last knockdown. Let's see. A good left hook. Well, now you know what? It didn't look like it landed very well.
Sure didn't.
Well, but guess what? If Paris Alexander didn't want the fight to be stopped, he shouldn't have gone down from it. But, you know, you can make the case, I guess, based upon the way that knockdown happened, that maybe they could have let it go down a little longer.
He got right up.
Yeah, that was, he was knocked down actually by a forearm.
Yeah. He had been hit with a pretty good left hook before that. So when you look at it in replay, you realize it wasn't a clear shot.
All right, let's go to Michael Buffer and get the official time and such.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Chuck Hassett calls a halt to this bout. The official time, 1 minute, 52 seconds of round number two. The winner by TKO, the pride of East L.A., the Golden Boy, Oscar.
Delahoya, the Golden Boy, lives up to that billing as he whacks out Paris Alexander. Referee stops the fight in the second round, and we'll be back to talk with Delahoya after this. Folks, and with good reason, he's without Wednesday.
Yeah, unmarked and practically untouched in this fight, but that's nothing new for Oscar Delahoya. Now, Percy Alexander this morning, and he's a guy, by the way, as we mentioned, had gone six rounds with Frank Pena to a draw. Frank Pena, who you saw earlier this evening, a guy who was on your level as an amateur. You whacked him out early. When did you know? Do you know what the first big punch you hit him with that he was in trouble?
And actually, the first big punch that I hit him with was a straight jab, which kind of dropped him. And I landed it right on the button, and I felt it on my glove, on my fist. And it was a pretty good punch, a pretty strong punch. And, you know, I thought he was going to be a lot tougher. In some paper, he said that, you know, I'm 0-0, I'm really turning pro, that my other two opponents weren't nothing, so he's really going to give me a challenge. And I was really scared coming into this fight. And
Scared might be overstating it, Oscar.
I'm concerned. I was pretty scared, okay. Concerned, and worried about he's going to give me a good match. And, you know, I mean, I feel good. I'm well-trained, and I was training very hard. And, you know, as you can see, I stopped him in the second round and won again.
Yeah, you did. And, you know, the thing is that I wasn't meaning to make fun of the fact when you said you were scared. The thing is, he was a guy that should have been in at least longer than he was, we would presume.
Yes, I would believe he would have came out stronger and was going to last all the fights that he had to leave. The distance, he's gone 10 rounds, he's gone 6 rounds with Frank Pena. I thought he would last a little longer. But like I said, I mean, we're well-trained and ready for anybody.
Seems like you're throwing every punch as if it's a knockout punch.
Yes, I want to throw every punch with a knockout. Kind of like throw every punch that, I mean, if it lands, it'll knock him out. And that's what we want to do. That's what we work on in the gym. And we're going to keep on doing that.
Be back in February fighting, and then in March, 10-rounder against Jeff Mayweather.
10-rounder. 8-rounder.
8-rounder, okay.
With Jeff Mayweather. And it's going to be a pretty good fight. He switches softball. He switches right-handed. And it's going to be a tough match, but we're prepared for it.
You're on the quick road, my friend, and a good one.
Thank you. Thank you.
All right, congratulations. Okay. Oscar De La Hoya is moving it. Light speed. What is that they say on Star Trek? Warp speed. That's it. We'll be back. We're going to show you Roberto Duran and Sugar Ray Leonard, number one. I mean it.